Welcome to Countdown. I'm Mark Barton in London. It is 7:30 here. Investors from around the world are gathering in Tel Aviv to listen to the latest business ideas from budding entrepreneurs. The IXTLV is a showcase for startup talent to pitch to secure investment. Our Middle East editor, Elliot Gotkin, was there. A bit of an eclectic bunch of companies, Elliot.
Very much so, Mark. I should say that many of these companies had already had their first round of financing. They were looking for more money to expand their businesses and move them towards profitability. But certainly yesterday, for example, we had a company called Giraffic, which looks to accelerate download speeds for video by using idle capacity on networks and try to reduce the annoyance of buffering. There was a company called Pose, which is seeking to revolutionise the cash register for small and medium-sized businesses, and one for the 23 million electric guitar players around the world. And I'm always struck me, Mark, as a bit of a secret headbanger yourself, I'm sure. For those 23 million people around the world, there was something for them too.
Some Israelis want to be rock stars. Luckily for the economy, many more want to set up their own tech companies.
We invented the SoundPad, the GTC SoundPad, which it's a technology, it's a cutting-edge technology that provides guitar players with new sounds, tremendous original effects, and a vast range of new musical options previously unavailable to electric guitar players.
This was performance with a purpose, namely getting these men to part with their cash. Last year, venture capital firms lavished $1.4 billion on Israeli tech companies. That's lower than 2011 due to a weaker global economy. But the concentration of startups at roughly one for every 1,450 Israelis is still growing and remains the highest in the world.
Listen to the people that are similar to you.
Serendip's music recommendation service is among them, though it had a mixed reception.
I think it's okay. It's a go ahead.
I love music too, but I think this one would be a no for me. Really, really tough space.
Yeah, we have a mantra that nobody ever made money in music. So
we started with our debt.
Bucket, which helps debtors and creditors bypass collection agencies, fared better. BBVA's investment arm, for one, seemed impressed.
The reason why I liked it is that they are focusing that alternative lending space in which banks are not really good at. We are not tackling the opportunity there, and we are not servicing our customers in the right way.
Among the Israeli startups looking for funding here is Mingle, which enables pubs and bars to apply dynamic pricing, in other words, changing what they charge for booze depending on the busyness of their establishment. And if you enjoy yourself too much with that one, there's always Alkahoot, which offers you a breathalyzer in your pocket.
Zero. Well, what did you expect?
And I'm sure there aren't any journalists out there that could make use of that final product, Mark.
That product obviously wasn't working, Elliot, if it said 0.00. You are heading back there later. Well, who's pitching today?
Well, I should say, in the interest of science, I did actually take a couple of sips just to see if it did read the alcohol level, and it did indeed bump up a little bit. But that was only after I'd finished working. But certainly today, there are many more tech companies that are going to be pitching to investors. There's a company called Trofit, for example. This one is a kind of reward scheme. And so instead of advertising, targeting customers with adverts, it's giving them rewards. And if they save or use those rewards, then apparently it translates into better customer relationships with those companies. That's one particular company. There's also that Alkahoot is going to be pitching for money as well. And there's also some other biotech companies and gaming companies that are all going there for the second day of this IXTLV event. Some of them have 6 minutes to pitch. That's six companies pitching for 6 minutes in front of six potential investors. Unlucky number 666 for some, but some of them later today are just going to have 3 minutes. So very much an elevator pitch, albeit a rather long one for an elevator ride, Mark.
Elliot, thank you very much. Fascinating stuff. Andrew Popper.